Yeah, and it's got one screw going through it here and a small one fitted here. Yeah, okay, so then raise this. I have to put my sight up first. Yeah, there's actually a little ball bearing, spring-loaded ball bearing down under there, which latches into this little hole here. Yeah, so that clips up like so, covers up. Now here are some of the details I've left out of my plans. I have a pipe which runs all the way through the receiver and comes out the back. Right, that's one pipe all the way through that has the spring inside it and the bolt. Now on the end, on this end here, we actually have the bolt, a big heavy piece of steel bar running down inside the pipe to approximately this location here, and it's got a tapped hole, and this bolt here fits down through it. And what I've done is I've got a steel plate which is folded like a piece of U-section steel. It's folded and it fits down over the two sides of this round pipe to simulate the bolt inside the 30 cal of the original one. Now this gave me a way to weld a nut onto here and secure a cocking lever to it. Now here, this is just a piece of steel which I've welded on to the pipe which runs through and out the rear of the 30 cal. Yeah. Now this here is where I clip my ammunition to, the 7.62s as I use. You can see it simulates the link on a machine gun belt. Right, this is a very simplified version of a 30 cal. Not excessively simplified, I suppose, but you can see there are some differences. Mine is quite considerably lighter, which is quite a good thing in a lot of cases. Overall, they're the same size. Mine is just lighter because it's not made out of quite as heavy steel. Here inside, you can see the underneath. Now in reality, the old spent cartridges would drop out the rear, sorry, would drop out the underside of the 30 cal at this point here. Yeah, the cartridges would spew out the bottom. Now you could make a blank firing version of one of these, but I won't go into details about all that. Now I can actually put a 9mm blank inside here. In fact, there's a dead one in there at the moment. Now I've placed a dead one in there just to cushion impact, but what happens is there is a small bar which simulates a dummy barrel that comes forward inside the barrel jacket and has a side discharge venting, but it's only a small hole. Now when the gun fires the blank, the actual blank cartridge has got such a small hole for the gas to escape through that it actually causes the case to eject backwards and it drops out the bottom of the gun. But to load it, you have to actually put your fingers, cock the gun and actually insert the blank manually one at a time. So that's all it will do. It will fire one blank and eject it so that you can put another one in. But you know, it works. It produces a bang, makes it look like it does something. This here is my duplication of the mounting system for putting it on the Jeep, which I'll show you in a minute. Here you can see the differences between mine and the real one. But most people don't know. Here I've got stamped 30 cal Browning. Can't remember if this one has it on the top. Some do, some don't. It's the front sight. No, it's not got it stamped on this model. You can see the differences there between mine and this one. Front of the barrel. Okay, there are variations on the barrel design. I've opted for doing this system, which has produced a slight step in the nose, the front, the muzzle of the barrel, right? This is only a barrel jacket, I should say, really. I've used an outer pipe and then an inner pipe, and I've plug welded and filed it down, and then I've oil blued the whole gun. This one has got a slightly tapered barrel to it, the original, but they're not all like this. Some of them are like this one. There are variations in a number of points on the guns. They're not all exactly the same. You can see this sight here can also be used in its flat operating position. I haven't done that on mine. I've just made mine so that it has to actually be up, but it's easy to make a sight with a piece sticking up here, yeah, and a little notch. Other points, this is actually adjustable on a real one. But I didn't go to that trouble. It's just a replica. It's an ornament for mounting on a Jeep. And so, and such, you know, so, There's the original side I showed you before. Now there's mine. It's just simplified. Most people will not know the difference. There's my plate here. You can see I had two holes drilled in there, and then I've plug welded them and ground it down. But it's got the same three holes here as on the original one. See, this is pretty much a large piece of cast steel, whereas I have folded mine. Now I'll show you the inside, and I've taken the four screws out on my replica 30 caliber here, and this here is the trigger mechanism. Now, you can see the way it functions by pulling the trigger up here. That sir moves downwards, and all I have is a split pin running through the center of this. Now, can you see inside? It's a three-piece trigger mechanism. And what we have here is I've actually got a spring mounted and it presses the trigger mechanism back into the up position. It presses on the base of the sear. It's just a bolt holding a piece of spring steel. So it's very simple. The trigger is actually welded to this piece of the mechanism here, and it has a linking bar which connects from here down to the base of the sear, which you can't actually see unless I strip it down, but you should be able to get the idea of how it works. Very simple. By using this system, it ensures that when the bolt travels back inside the pipe, inside the receiver, that's inside this pipe in the receiver casing, when that moves backwards, what we have here, remember me saying there is a piece of metal fixed around the actual pipe. Right, what I've done then is I've welded a plate across underneath the pipe. See, one weld, second weld there. Now that there is what the sear mechanism catches in on. By doing this, ensures that the mechanism runs smoothly. I've put plenty of grease on the outside of the pipe here. As you can see it there. So that is what the sear catches on.